Welcome back everyone! We've been hard at work since the last mobile update and a lot of things have been added, so we want to give you guys a sneak peek on what has changed in the meantime. And of course also what we have planned in the upcoming months. For those of you who don't know, Mobro is a universal data visualization app that we develop. It lets you create your own custom dashboards that can be displayed locally on your PC, an external device like a Raspberry Pi, Android phone or just a browser window anywhere in your local network. So join us and let's take a look what we achieved in the last months. We've gotten a lot of feedback since the initial preview release. Our patrons have been hard at work testing our app and giving us feedback on Discord. Thanks to them, we were able to fix some issues that they found, and we are now defining the last features for the initial public release of the app. So we wanted to start off with a big thank you to everyone helping us actively improving Mobro and raising it to the next level. If you're also interested in testing out the current preview version and get in contact with us on Discord, check out our Patreon or head over to mobro.app. The links will be in the video description. First things first, let's take a look at what changed in regards to our data plugins. When we open up our marketplace, we can see that we have added 3 new plugins since the last video. The first is a media plugin, which you guys actually voted for in our plugin poll we did on Patreon. This plugin provides metrics on the currently playing song, artist, volumes, and possibly more in the future. Since Open Weather came in second place, we decided to implement this as well. It integrates current weather data from the Open Weather API into Mobro, so you can now enjoy your weather outside, indoors, on your monitoring dashboard. The latest addition is our CoinGecko plugin, which allows you to track all your favorite cryptocurrencies. We are already thinking about more future plugins. But what would you like to monitor in the future? If you have any ideas, drop them down below in the comments. We are also going to open up the app and let you guys create your own plugins, but more on that later in the video. Similar to plugins, we have also added and updated our widget packs. Our charts widget pack is now vastly more configurable, and every chart has now the possibility to change colors based on thresholds. The single value chart is now able to display date metrics in a nice way and convert them automatically to the correct time zone. The line chart is also able to store a customizable amount of data points now instead of the previously fixed 20 points. We have also added our beloved Dubadar widget pack to make transitioning from the old beta version to the new version as easy as possible for our users. This widget pack includes all the widgets that the old Dubadar theme had to offer, so it's possible to recreate every dashboard from the old beta version, but now with the added benefit of combining it with all the new widget packs available in the marketplace. The app itself also received a couple of improvements and new features. We added logos and descriptions to the items in the marketplace to make it more visually appealing, and also give some information on what certain widget packs and plugins are capable of. The monitoring overview page has gotten a lot of love and attention too. You can now easily see how many plugins you have installed and how many metrics those plugins provide together. Same goes for the widget packs overview page, where you can now see how many widgets you can use in your dashboard. We also changed the layout of the plugin and widget pack cards to make the information more readable. Plugins now also support a couple more actions. You can now enable and disable plugins, so you no longer need to fully uninstall a plugin if you just want to turn it off temporarily. In addition, you can now also simply reload plugins just in case some unexpected error or behavior occurs. Sometimes a quick restart is all that is required. Some of our new plugins are a bit more complex and require some configuration in order to work. For instance, an API key for the Open Weather plugin. So we implemented plugin settings that can be configured directly in Mobro as well. If we check the Open Weather plugin in Mobro, you can open the settings via the three dots menu. Here you can enter the previously mentioned API key that the plugin needs to access the Open Weather API. Another example would be the new CoinGecko plugin, which allows you to configure which specific cryptocurrencies you want to track. Since settings are now available, we added a few options to existing plugins as well. All of them now allow you to configure the metric update frequency, and some, like the Libre Hardware Monitor plugin, also allow you to configure which components to monitor. So the plugin no longer constantly pulls data from sensors you're not actually interested in anyway. In the monitoring tab, we also added a new metric explorer. This can be used to explore all the metrics of all the plugins you have currently installed. This should make it easier to see what data a plugin can provide you before searching for it in the dashboard builder, or to simply give you a nice overview of your data if you just want to check a specific value real quick without having to add it to a dashboard. What you're seeing here is just the first version of the new metric explorer, so this will be further improved in the future. In the dashboard builder, we tried to improve usability by adding a couple of new keyboard shortcuts. It's now possible to delete widgets by pressing the delete key. You can copy and paste them with Ctrl C and V, and move widgets around with arrow keys for a pixel-perfect positioning. Since some of our patrons had quite huge dashboards with hundreds of charts on a Raspberry Pi, those Pis had quite a lot to do. That's why you now have the possibility to disable animations for a given dashboard config. That eases the workload on those poor Pis for huge dashboards tremendously. Some of the metrics a plugin can provide might be dates and times from a different time zone than the one Mobro is running in. That resulted in those dates and times being displayed incorrectly. To ensure that those dates and times are always correct, we added a time zone select in the settings of Mobro, which is the time zone of the user by default, to convert those dates correctly on a dashboard. Since some of our patrons had issues with the installation of our plugin service when updating Mobro from the old version to the new one, we introduced a service overview about all the services the app uses. Here we can restart, stop and start services if any issues arise. If any of those services isn't running correctly, it will be shown up in the bar up here. For those of you with an eye for detail, you might have realized that we also changed the icon for the app. Previously, Mobro was running always using our ModBros logo, which was actually incorrect since you already had a custom logo for Mobro anyway. Small changes definitely matter, since that looks a lot better in the taskbar. Maybe a small change for users, but a huge one for us, is the export for debug information from the settings in Mobro. This magic button exports all the logs and information we might need to fix a bug that you guys tell us about in Discord. Previously, we always had to point our patrons to the log files we thought might include a hint, just to point them to yet another log file afterwards. This definitely helped us quite a lot. And last but not least in the app, we changed the workflow for users to log into Mobro and link their account with Patreon. Previously, users had to log in at our website at modbros.com to link their Patreon account there. But now it's just one simple button press in the account settings in Mobro and voila, we have our Patreon account connected to our ModBros account. Of course, a new version is not always about the new features, but also fixing existing ones. So here's a short list of all the bugs that we fixed over the last couple of months. By introducing the marketplace, Mobro became a model application that can be extended by plugins to integrate all sorts of different data from all sorts of sources. What we ultimately aim for is to allow and enable everyone to develop plugins for Mobro and then share them via the marketplace. Think of it as being a platform similar to Steam, well, on a much, much smaller scale, of course. So we have some good and some bad news for all the developers among you. Good news first. We've already created an SDK and an accompanying documentation on how to develop a plugin for Mobro. In fact, all of the existing plugins are already built using this SDK. Mobro plugins are written in C#, and the SDK is available as a package on NuGet, and of course, also open sourced on GitHub. By the time this video goes live, we will also open source the repositories of all the existing plugins, so that you guys will have some examples to look at. You will find the documentation on developer.mobro.app. Link will be in the video description. Now for the bad news. While the marketplace obviously already works, there's no UI yet for you guys to easily publish and manage your plugins, should you want to develop one. That's one of the big projects we'll still need to work on in the future. But there's an already functioning REST API in place for the marketplace that can be used to publish plugins. So if you really want to start developing and are willing to read some documentation, and you know how to use Postman, just contact us and we will hook you up with an API key so you can give it a try. Now, everything that I just outlined for plugins is of course true for widget packs as well, as they are also available via the marketplace. We've also already created a separate SDK using TypeScript and React for widget packs that we use to create all the existing ones. The documentation for that SDK just isn't finished yet. Once that is done, you will be able to find it on the same page, developer.mobro.app. But enough of that. If you want to check out the new Mobro version, just head over to mobro.app and have a look at the new page we've set up for Mobro. Currently, this version is still exclusively in preview for our Patreon members, but we're aiming for a public release this summer. So there will be finally a free version of the new Mobro app as well. However, being a Patreon and connecting your account will have its benefits, as you will have access to certain premium features, and of course we're going to include you in the development process as well. So don't forget to toss us a like to beat the YouTube algorithm, subscribe to the channel if you want to stay tuned and like the content like this, and we'll see you guys next time.